pair of birds came with the house, the sale of the house, and that was Goosey and Lucy. And during the spring, they laid me some beautiful goose eggs. From there on, I was hooked. So now I have probably 180 birds. They all have names. They have their own personalities, and you can get your inspiration from them. Day that basically nothing can go wrong. Everything fits. You don't have to recut. It just goes together real good. And then you can have days that you've planned out the egg on paper, have it all measured out, and not a single thing goes right with it.
How all the changes came about my way.
Oh, there's a lot more to learn. I think you learn every day. Even if you take something as simple as working with polymer clay and putting it on an egg, there's lessons that you learn. The weather has a lot to do with it. So you can have one egg turn out real good one day and the weather be changing and it won't be so great the next day.
I don't think I risk another these days.
If you're doing a filigree, it's freestyle. So basically, you can draw on your egg with a pencil. Or if you're good enough, you don't have to do that. You can just freehand it and go. Basically, you're using a tool that goes 400,000 RPMs a minute. And you just start carving. You do what you want. Working on doing eggs approximately 9 years. I guess where I want to go with it is that people are aware that it's an art form, that it's unique, that you can take a simple egg, perfect in form, and create an art piece from it. You can do anything.
Don't confront me.